Odessen, huh? Could it be there's really a place where no one wants to kill us?
I handpicked it myself. We'll be safe.
Are we sure it's wise to leave Scorpio in control of the bridge?
Got the ship locked down. She can't go anywhere without my approval.
I hope you're right.
So, why this world?
Remote, unsettled, and strong in the Force. But unlike Korriban or Tython, Odessen is altogether balanced.
How did you find it?
I've always had a strong affinity with the Force. It's what set me on this path to begin with. Led me to forge a certain alliance all those years ago.
With the Republic?
I meant with you. Well, here we are. This is your new alliance.
It's a good start.
We all had a hand in getting here, but you've been the center. You made it possible. Show them what you're made of.
I'd like everyone's attention. The galaxy as we knew it is gone. The institutions we know have fallen, but we can't let that be a source of panic or defeat. We have an opportunity to build something together, an alliance each of us can be vested in. We don't all share the same ideologies, but every one of you is here because you believe we can transcend our differences. I believe it too. Either we succeed together, or we fail alone. Let's not fail.
Like what you've done with the place.
Theron Shan.
Hadn't seen you in a while. Wasn't sure you'd remember me.
It's great to see you again, Theron.
Good. Wasn't sure based on what Lana said you went through, what you're going through. Been a long 5 years. Feels like everything's changed.
You got better looking.
I don't know about that, but hey, I'll take it. Since I left the SIS, Lana's brought me in to manage operations. But before we get into all the more or less official stuff, I've got something for you.
You found my people?
No luck so far, but...
Needs work! A lot of work!
When you have a moment, it's time for that official stuff. I'll be inside.
A squadron run like that will fail without detailed schematics. We need hangar positions, defensive capabilities. It would also help if we understood how to disrupt the power core.
I cannot divine such information nor pray to the gods of science. All I can do is speculate. Unless, that is, we could extract such data in secret.
Don't look at me. I've snuck into some crazy places, but stations like these are another deal altogether.
All right, we'll table it for now. We have company.
Need some help?
With Arkan's battle stations? We will, as soon as we understand them. We're building a healthy alliance, but it's not enough. The core worlds are still under the threat of Arkan's considerable reach. Now, I've assembled a team of specialists to help tackle the big questions and find potential recruits.
Dr. Javard Ilip-Ogarab, if you recall. I'm no biologist, but I admit I'm fascinated by the effects of long-term carbonite poisoning on your mental faculties.
Baywan Ego, former fleet admiral in the Republic Navy. Discharged, but still in this fight.
Hilo Viz. Sure you've heard of me. Broke the toughest blockade in galactic history. Republic's greatest outlaw hero, basically.
Your visage surfaced in my trials. I'm the Mystic Zana Rey. I will assist you.
Hello, all of you. And no, Doctor, you can't experiment on my brain.
A pity. Perhaps another time. If I may be so bold, I would ask a favor of you. I have my trained eye on a promising recruit. A Gan, of all creatures. If you'd like to go over the details, you may find me in my splendid new laboratory.
So, that's the team. Any questions?
What do I have to do to find out what you've been up to all these years?
We'll get a chance to talk soon.
Well, if it isn't the new commander. We didn't get much of a chance to talk earlier. The Alliance needs a lot to keep it going. Food, equipment, weapons, ships. And it needs to get everything without popping up on Arkan scanners. That kind of work takes a true professional. Someone who knows where to look, how to ask, and who to ask. So, naturally, your friends went and found the best. Yours truly, to run the supply into this operation. I make sure you get what you need without raising any eyebrows. All at perfectly reasonable contract rates, plus hazard premiums and a discretion fee. Fact is, a lot of freighter captains are happy just to have steady work from someone who won't shoot them in the back when it's time to pay up. All the same, I have to admit I've stretched my network of contacts pretty thin. If this alliance is going to get much bigger, we're going to need a lot more help. Smugglers, bounty hunters, maybe even pirates. Anyone who has useful skills or just knows their way around the underworld. You find anyone good, bring them in. I've always got my ear to the ground, too. If I find any promising leads, I'll let you know. Oh, one last thing. While you're out and about, you ever find a Deveronian by the name of Galt Renault or Tiresias Loci? You let me know. Need to put a few holes into that backstabber. Long story.
We meet again. To share your company twice after so many years. I did not believe destiny could be so whimsical. The intervening years have not treated you well. You know, I still look back fondly upon our collaboration on the Keb. Toppling tomorrow, I had hoped to be able to work together again, and now we have been given the opportunity. Let us not squander it with idle chatter. On to business. It is no secret that against the Eternal Empire, we stand at a massive technological disadvantage. In fact, that is almost an understatement. My role here is to coordinate the Alliance effort to understand the Eternal Empire technology, and to develop our own to bring us to an even footing. The task is daunting indeed, which is what makes it exciting. To succeed, we must gather scientists, researchers, and representatives from the galaxy's many sentient species for their fresh perspectives. For now, I must return to my art. Without even saying a word, you have managed to leave me inspired. Truly impressive. I must create.
Greetings. I am not the first mystic you have met. As was seen, we have built an enclave for those gifted in the Force. Here they will meditate, train, and grow. I also meditate, awaiting visions of those who will yet join us. This is my place. I have also brought several Voss training in the Force. The Enclave must grow, but it requires your support to do so. I meditate. My visions reveal those who might join. You will attempt to recruit them. As outsiders like to say, good luck.
Well, if it isn't the new commander. It's a pleasure to be able to work with you again, sir. Your work at Kuat was impressive, to say the least. I really do wish we had more time to catch up, but the Eternal Empire's not sitting around, so neither can we. If only it was as easy to send the Eternal Empire packing as you did those imps back on Kuat. Sorry, sir. That remark was totally inappropriate, given our current alliance. At any rate, my job is to coordinate the Alliance's military and strategic intelligence assets. I'm looking forward to working with you to enhance our military capacity. Let me know if and when you're looking to help. We've got plenty of work to go around.
To old friends and new allies.
I'll drink to the second part.
Do you even recall the last time we relaxed?
I can. It was 2.6 million years ago, and Senyu was still a jerk.
And to think I was going to sing for you all tonight.
You were what? Ah, come on. I have got to hear this.
Too late now.
Theron, you can't let the weight of the galaxy rest on your shoulders all the time.
Isn't that why you talked me into coming here? To lighten your load?
I brought you here because you're good.
Hey, look who it is. Don't worry, didn't really start without you.
Yes, we've only just begun. I wasn't sure you'd attend.
A chance to unwind after what we've been through is exactly what we need.
You are exactly correct. Now get this guy to cheer up.
I'm reasonably cheery. I'm joining in. And now you are too.
I was hoping to have a talk with one of you first.
Yeah? Who'd you have in mind?
Come on, Theron. Let's catch up.
You got it.
Is there any food, or did you eat it all?
Hey, I mean, I probably did, but come on.
And with the way everything changed, the SIS didn't feel right for me anymore, so I walked away. Kept up with my contacts, pretty much did what I was already doing, just not for the Republic. Not for anything. Against Zakul.
Were you able to make any headway?
I have found sympathetic Zakulans, but not many. A lot of folks moved out here from the Core Worlds. I'm having better luck recruiting them, but they're also under suspicion of being dissidents.
I hear Suresh installed a puppet chancellor.
She's pulling the strings, no doubt about it. Made my decision to move along that much easier. Suresh has her supporters, a lot of them. She'll wind up grinding the Republic to dust. You watch.
What about your mother?
The Grandmaster? No. The Jedi Order got scattered, plucked apart, and she decided to go somewhere. Didn't say where. No one's heard from her, far as I know. And I guess Lana's filled you in on the rest. I want you to know, I'll do everything I can to keep things running smoothly around here.
So, you'll take care of anyone who needs you?
Not just anyone. I'm sorry I couldn't be there to thaw you out. Look at all you've accomplished. Everyone who chose to rally behind you. I haven't been one of those destiny people in a long time, but this sure feels like it.
If you mean being here with you, I agree.
Lana, I have a confession to make. I tried the roast gorak.
What? When did you even have time?
I tried it, and I didn't love it, but the sauce had this zing to it. I really wish I had some.
Looks like things are winding down.
Len and Tora got into a drinking contest. It ended poorly.
Hey, have you seen Senya? Has anyone seen Senya?
Koth, she's not hunting you anymore. You're going to have to trust her eventually.
She fought her own daughter.
I know. I hear you. Crew needs to be back to work in an hour. That should be fun.
I need to schedule some meetings.
Reminds me of my advisor days.
Thanks, all of you. It means a lot that you're here.
Likewise, Outlander.
Tora, Len, let's go, you miserable lightweights.
Oh, shut up!
It's impressive, you know. People from all over the galaxy want to stand behind you.
We'll need every last one of them and more to make this work.
I was worried Heskel had blinded you with his certainty, like he did with the Scions. He would have them die as he did because their deaths were foreseen. Their visions provide great insight, but they're not infallible.
Reminds me of the Heralds of Zildrok.
There's another leader who paid for his certainty. Say what you will about Valkorion, but he at least considered the viewpoints of others. He listened to me, most of the time. He didn't... He would never have done what... What... Arkin...
What is it?
I told you before that Arkin had a brother, Thaxan. They were inseparable until his death. Valen told me during our fight. Arkin murdered Thaxan. His own brother. Maybe if I had raised him.
Your fight with Valen. What happened?
What she had to say. It struck me down to my core. Paralyzed me. She slipped away. Now, more than ever, I realize my children must be stopped. And that I have to make peace with the choices I've made. Whatever you've done to get here. I hope you can do the same.
She raises a good question. How do you look back on your path to this moment?
I made the decisions I felt were right. That's about all any of us can ever do.
A life without regret is a life well lived. Though I suppose it remains to be seen whether you will ultimately succeed. Personally, I see you defeating Arkin. Others on this world disagree.
What does that mean? Who disagrees?
You will learn soon enough.
Out there somewhere. Our own father plotting against us.
He's not the only one. After I told Mother that you killed Vexen, she probably wants your head. But it's not a problem. You have the throne, the fleet, this whole empire. You are as safe from her as can be.
I wish Vexen could be here now. He'd see I was right to challenge Father. Imagine it. The three of us ruling this empire, as it was meant to be ruled.
I'd like it if Thaxan were here too. But that's no longer possible.
Doesn't matter. Father has a new favorite. He wants the Outlander to take all of this from you.
I'll die before I let that happen to us.
Of course you will.
Lon and I thought it would be a good idea to call a meeting. Hope you can spare the time since, you know, it's basically about you.
What is all this?
It's your first official speech as Alliance Commander.
I'll have to thank everyone for their vote of confidence.
There was no vote, no meetings, no debates. It's simply the way it is. The way it's been since the day you arrived. Everyone knows it. It's just official now.
I thought you hated titles.
I hate having one, but I do love granting them. They're looking to you to guide them to greatness as only you can. Take them there.
All of us here, we know about loss, don't we? We've lost loved ones, friends. We've been beaten down time and again. Our lives have been taken from us. It almost feels like our destiny. But not one of you has given up. You've stuck it out through your losses. You've come together to build, to create, to fight. And I appreciate each and every one of you.
Working together, the galaxy won't have to live under the threat of a tyrant.
Together, we will remove Arkan from the throne. And we will prevail.
They have come so far.
Indeed, they have.
They still have far to go. But at this rate, they could one day pose a challenge to the Eternal Empire.
Perhaps. A pity so many of them will have to die.
You.
The gravestone, the Outlander, where are they?
Patrols in 5 sectors report no sign of either. Perhaps they're just figments of our imagination.
Someone knows the truth.
I know that look. You're about to order something wonderful.
Choose one populated planet in each of the 5 sectors. Dispatch the fleet to bombard them.
For how long?
Until they're dust. Someone knows. Someone will talk. But only if we give them a reason.
You summoned us, Theron. You said you had leads on allies?
Leads, yes. Commitments, no. Lana's still working on the major players. Meanwhile, there's a potential ally on Zakuul we've been ignoring. Firebrand.
Your information is faulty. Firebrand's not on our side.
Firebrand?
An unidentified individual who arrived on Zakuul 2 years ago. She's carried out bombings in the Spire targeting military and civilian venues.
That makes her a terrorist, not an ally.
It makes her both. Look, I'm not thrilled with the idea, but we're in no position to get choosy. She's done as much damage as we have.
The Republic doesn't target civilians, or support those who do. Remember what we're fighting for.
I'm just saying we talk. Besides, look around this place. Not many clean hands here.
What does she want?
Based on her rambling audio manifestos, she's an anarchist looking to bring down Emperor Arkin's perfect society.
There are elements of the Spire's population who create artwork in her honor. They even trade holograms of her handiwork.
If she's survived fighting Zakul so long and she's connected with the populace, she's worth investigating.
All right, we make contact. Scorpio, you're the expert on the Zakul underworld.
The Lady of Sorrows could offer high-yield explosives to draw her out.
Proceed. I'll head for Zakul shortly.
I'm back up if you need it.
Just be careful. Arkin's still hunting for you, and Firebrand may not be the ally we're hoping.
The meeting is arranged. Firebrand expects to purchase explosives from my representatives. Transmitting location.
Your time like the present.
Could use a hand.
About five levels down, there's this one skytrooper. Totally wrong program. Likes to give back rubs. Best thing Zakul ever did.
Well, I know where I'm going next.
You shut up. You? Why do I think you don't have my explosives?
You're Firebrand. The Lady of Sorrows told you about a meet here. I don't have your bombs, but I'm not here to fight.
Well, that's all disappointing.
You might be surprised, Firebrand.
Just Kaleo is fine. Firebrand's what the locals call me to brighten their sad little lives. And I guess you're the big mean Outlander. I heard what you did at the droid factory. Place almost melted down. Would have been more impressive if it had, but the blackout was kind of fun. What brings you here?
One thing you'll learn about me. I don't like it when civilians are caught in the crossfire. My war is against Arkin.
Oh yeah? So why are you bothering me?
I'm building an alliance against Arkin. You've got skills and resources I need.
I'm not a good team player. Look, I'm in the middle of something big. You kind of stole my thunder with the factory, and you lied about bringing explosives. So that's 2 points against you.
We also just saved you from skytroopers.
Yeah, true. And there are more coming, so I could use backup. You want to tag along, we can talk and work.
I'm going to need details. But not here.
Like I said, you stole my thunder. Now I'm stealing it back.
I'll leave you to it. There's a contact I need to meet.
First stop is the old world power junctions. You know how to cold rig a detonator?
keep an eye out for skytroopers. I've got to wire a jury-rigged ion grenade into the power junction. I mess up, we all fry. That blackout you caused shows the whole system's vulnerable. You know about the Overwatch?
Some sort of command center.
Smart girl. Overwatch is where they run half the droids in the Spire. Skytroopers, building crews, med units, you name it. We blow a couple of junctions at once, Overwatch security goes down. Force fields, scanners, no power. We walk right in.
This whole city runs on machines. If we interfere with the Overwatch controls, the Spire will practically shut down.
Yeah, these people. The droids do everything for them. Most of the locals sit around drooling while their tech feeds and protects them. We're gonna show them real life for a day or two. No droids. Just until it's fixed.
The plan might work, but what's the goal? If the damage gets repaired, all we're doing is causing chaos.
Look, you came to me. You don't like my methods? I don't really care. But I'll throw in a bonus. Tavor Slen, the Overwatch administrator? The data he needs to run those droids is pretty much a blueprint for the city. You ever plan an attack here, you'll need that data. Defenses, vulnerabilities, everything. So we get inside, we both get something good.
This Theron Shan, is he another knight of Z'Kul?
Nah, piece of work, but no powers. I plan to shoot him in the head. Come on, we better get to the next junction before the skytroopers show. Okay, we're set. But I've got to stick around a minute. Supposed to meet a contact.
What kind of contact?
A local. Won't take long. But get too close and you'll scare her off.
Firebrand? Everything's ready. I've got the Overwatch data and the rest. The rest is done too.
Good girl. Who says you can't get your hands dirty?
Listen, the others, they're out. They won't say anything, but they're getting their scars fixed. It's not fun anymore.
Yeah, well, they're morons. We've got each other.
I need to go.
Don't forget, you cause me problems. Those scars can get deeper. Idiots and cowards. Every one of them. I've met Alderaanian nobles less pampered. More backbone, too.
Care to explain what that exchange was about?
I've picked up a few fans over the years. That girl? Daughter of the Overwatch administrator.
Why is she helping you?
Same reason they all did. They're sheltered kids and rebellion is taboo. They don't really want Z'Kul overthrown. But almost getting blown up? Getting a few scars before the droids make them pretty again? Oh, that's a mark of pride.
That woman said the others were out, that they're getting their scars healed.
Apparently, some outlander turned up and soured my pals on Rebellion. It's too close to home now. One more power conduit, then the show starts. Let's make a trade. I checked up on you after you blew up the factory. You used to be someone before you disappeared. You're too smart not to have an angle. You tell me what you're really after, I'll tell you why I'm on Z'Kul.
There's no secret agenda. Z'Kul is a threat to everything. And no one but me is in a position to stop it.
Totally selfless, huh? Want to know why I'm here? Before Z'Kul showed up, I had a freelance thing going. Had a partner, money, connections. We shot people. The war messed it up.
Who are you working for?
Gangs, others. We're not talking about that. Anyway, I landed on my feet, did odd jobs, owned a club, the usual. But I pay my debts. Long time ago, I had an anarchist cell in Rental.
I came to Z'Kul to start the work again.
You seem like more of an angry thrill-seeker than a believer in the cause of anarchy.
I was never hardcore about it, but I'm getting intellectual in my old age. Problem is, these people. Nothing hurts them. Blow up a building, droids rebuild. Cut up a scumwad, droids heal them. They don't know consequences. Even you killing their emperor just made them sniffle. They've barely got laws. But it's not anarchy if nothing matters. It's just a sugar rush.
Skytroopers nearby. I feel it.
Gotta move. We're rigged for the Overwatch, but we have to stop at my apartment first. Might be more droids there. You seem up for the challenge. This is it. My fans bought the furniture. Let me show you something.
You can see the Van Kesar bridge burning from here. No one's saying what happened, but I haven't seen anything like it.
My father will kill me if he knows I'm recording this. Firebrand struck again. The spaceport this time. I was so afraid. But I've never felt a rush like that before. Oh, thank Valkorion, the droids got me to safety.
Gray Market Hollows. They used to trade them like it was a game. Now, watch this.
Outlander's back! We were lucky she only caused a blackout. But what about next time? Z'Kul should be safe. It's always been safe. What happens now?
Tone's a little different on that one, huh? Suddenly blowing up a building matters.
They're awed by Firebrand, but they fear the Outlander.
I got lazy. Figured there was no way through to these people. Set my sights low with bridges and spaceports. But if you scared them, I can too. Guess I owe you for the wake-up call.
Now that the power junctions are rigged, can we strike at the Overwatch?
Pretty much. Force fields cycle in an hour, so we'll trigger the blackout then. Meantime, I've got maps and everything. Let's talk tactics. Everything goes down in the droid control center. You grab your data, I blow the machinery. And hopefully shoot the administrator.
You're sure the data's complete? The full city schematic?
Every droid in this city runs on those specs. You ever go to war with the Spire, that's your winning card. It's time. Step one, blow the junctions. That feels good. Come on. Expect droids, maybe a few knights, a grand old time.
Life is as empty without terror as without love. I would permit this creature's existence from my throne. She cannot truly threaten perfection, but only enhance it. But though chaos can be beautiful, it cannot last.
The data's coming through. Complete schematics for every building in the Spire.
I've got enough bombs here to slag the droid controls. Fancy automated city won't be automated anymore.
Damage can be repaired. I'm disappointed, Kaleo.
Tavor, I was worried you ran away.
You should have turned yourself into the Skytroopers. I can't protect you from this. Not your scheme, nor allying with the Outlander.
Actually, the Outlander came to ally with me. Meet Overwatch Administrator, Tavor Slenn.
I gave you friendship. a home, a purpose. You mock me.
I suggest you remove yourself from the building, along with anyone else alive. It's not safe.
I'm going nowhere without the traitor.
Tavor convinced me to sell out. Like I said before, when I saw I couldn't hurt the people here, I got lazy. He offered me a pretty cage. Nice house, free pass from the Sky Troopers. I could bomb little targets and he'd make sure no one got killed.
You sponsored her.
It was an outlet for our people's darker urges. A drop of poison to vaccinate against the disease of unrest.
You were also really into me. Then I remembered comfort isn't everything.
She is betrayal personified. Even you, Outlander, deserve better. My skills as a fighter are the model for our skytroopers. I will execute you both and make amends for my errors.
You poor, stupid, stupid, stupid man. You know your daughter helped me set up phase two.
What?
We're not just taking out droids for a day. I've got explosives planted around the city. Roads, factories, security stations, news centers. This time, when everything burns, no fire suppressor units, no medical droids, no skytroopers stopping riots.
You never mentioned that.
Surprise! You get it now, Tavor? You tried to use me. You all humiliated me. Now your happy city is going to hurt.
You're talking about hundreds of lives. They aren't responsible for what you've been through.
They were part of it. Every one of them. Besides, you should be backing me. I know what these people took from you. They stole your life. It'd feel good to hit back. I'll even let you do the honors. You blow the controls, I'll take the city.
It might feel good, but only briefly. Ruining the Spire won't bring back what we've lost.
Nothing will bring back what I lost.
Then stop obsessing over the past. Find something worth striving for.
Fine. We do it your way. But I'm still taking down the droids. Whatever your long-term plan is, it better end with Zakuul's empire crashing down. Or I'm coming for you, too.
Theron, you made it back.
Took a look at that data you stole. The schematic of the Spire is gonna come in handy.
City's going to take a while to recover from the droid shutdown. But no one got killed. Thanks.
So, Kaleo. She knows her stuff. We keeping her?
She knows her way around the Spire, and she can handle a gun. I don't think we can turn her away. But she's also a liar and a killer.
Understood. I'll get her a bunk and add her to the watch list.
You were the Lady of Sorrows?
Yes.
Guess you knew if I found out, I'd melt you down.
You two know each other?
Yeah, we're old buddies. Ask who built her sometime.
You will receive no satisfactory answer.
Not a bad little operation you've got here. Can't promise to stick around all the time, but when you're making a big move, say the word.
You make it sound like you've got other plans already.
Been a while since I left Sakul. Might be worth touching base with some old pals.
Anyone I should know?
Mostly thugs who want me dead.
Huts, Black Sun, Exchange. Someone must still like me.
Sounds like you've made your share of enemies.
I like to keep busy and I don't like to stay anywhere long. Lots of chances to know people. Done the piracy thing, Revolutionary Edge Brigade on Brental. Sponged off a senator's daughter once. One thing you learn about me, I always get by.
I'm sure you do.
I'll see you around then. And hey, good luck. We both lost a lot of years to Sakul. Time to start making up for it.
Millions dead. Their blood is on our hands.
We didn't destroy those worlds. Your children did.
The atrocities on those planets were committed to hurt the Alliance, but we're not responsible for them.
What are you talking about? What's happened now?
Warships from the Eternal Fleet bombarded 5 planets in a coordinated assault. The death toll is unimaginable. Whole cities leveled.
Arkhan issued a statement saying those worlds were protecting us and their destruction was justice for our attacks on Zakul. A lie, of course, but no one can prove it.
Arkhan's desperate. He can't find us, so he's taken the galaxy hostage.
There's only one way to stop this. Arkhan wants to isolate us. Let him. We should publicly deny we have allies on any planets.
You can't protect people from his reprisals, or stop those who believe in your alliance from joining it.
I just heard the news. We have to respond to Arkhan's attack.
No. That's precisely what he wants.
Is it?
We already have more objectives than resources, but we can make a course adjustment.
This kind of destruction will bring fear and chaos. We should do whatever we can to limit that.
I can get food and medical supplies to people who need them.
I'll organize security patrols to hold off any pirates or crime syndicates seeking to take advantage.
We're only delaying the inevitable. Sooner or later, my children must answer for what they've done.
Worlds to dust? I made hollows of it. Do you want a copy?
Father was on Zakul. He used the Outlander to attack our home.
I don't remember him being so funny when he was alive.
Am I laughing?
You've never laughed.
Our knights failed us. They must regain their honor. Send them to the Dueling Circle in pairs. Battle to the death.
Finding the Outlander will be harder with half our knights dead.
The survivors will be motivated. You know my command. Go.
Something on your mind?
I need your help with something.
You just wanted to get me alone.
Guilty, but business before pleasure. I passed a portion of that data you secured from Overwatch through an SIS contact of mine. Made a convincing invitation to some prospective allies in the Republic Special Forces.
Who is it you're planning to recruit?
I identified a sympathetic ear in the leader of the Republic's most decorated military unit. The data I gave over was enough to convince Havoc Squad to take leave of their official duties. I have it on good authority they're conducting an unscheduled operation on Zakul. My contacts set up a rendezvous, but it's up to you to sell them on this alliance.
I'm not seeing why you really need my help.
Havoc starting their own little war out here is basically treason. If it gets out that I had a hand in poaching them, well, I may find myself real short on friends back in the Republic.
Thank you.
I've got an anti-material rifle trained on your position and an unrestricted firing angle for at least 100 meters.
That's either really good or really bad, depending on your reasons for being here.
I represent an alliance forming against Emperor Arkan. We thought that might interest you.
So the message said. Stand down, Havoc. Don't take it personally. We aren't on the best terms with the Republic right now. Isn't that right, Theron?
Don't look at me. I was never here.
Major Jorgen, Havoc Squad. You're the one who supposedly killed the Emperor. Twice now.
I've stopped his plans, but I can't claim to have ended the Emperor's life.
Nor should you want to.
I'm tired of seeing Arkan stomp all over the galaxy. You want to finally start giving as good as you're getting? I've got a knot that can use your help.
What do you need?
Your landing didn't go unnoticed.
Hostiles! Here we go.
That won't be the last of them. Dengril, Zaven, split north. Abath, Torg, south. Kanner, take Theron, fastest route back to the camp. We'll regroup there. You, with me. We're covering the retreat.
Your squad is in good hands, Major.
The Sky Troopers have numbers and mobility. Losing them is going to take misdirection. I need a good vantage. Here. No sign of pursuit. Watch my six while I cover the retreat. This new Emperor. You've met him?
I have.
What's your assessment?
His father twisted and used up entire worlds according to his whims. Imagine being a child in that shadow.
Mine was not the only shadow the boy stood in.
Nothing but desperates left in this galaxy. The Republic you fought for, it doesn't exist. We gave the reins over to people who don't care how we win, just as long as we do. Suresh is all but a dictator now.
Can't the Senate keep her in check?
They don't even weigh in on military matters anymore.
Suresh and her puppet chancellor have everyone convinced the state of emergency requires executive action. She and her top brass just push through whatever suits their interests.
Never thought I'd miss bureaucrats butting into military matters. But what we gained in efficiency, we lost in soul.
This is a fight you can believe in, at least.
I'm holding you to that. Hold on. Got something. Civvies. And skytroopers. They're in trouble.
Distract them while I close the gap.
Affirmative.
You saved us.
Everyone all right? Anyone injured?
No, I don't think so. Thank you.
The skytroopers, they just came from nowhere. We've done nothing. We're no threat to the Spire, but the droids drove us from our homes and started burning everything.
Please, stop them like you did for us. There are others out there. Our families and friends, our homes. There'll be nothing left.
We'll stop the droids. Gather anyone you find away from the fighting.
Ready when you are.
You can't stay here. The skytroopers are burning everything. Run! It's clear if you run. Now! Help is waiting. Open up. You've got to move. There are others waiting to take you to safety.
Go! Just get out of here!
This is your fault! You did this to us!
We're not your enemy.
Skytroopers are probably searching for us.
They wanted for nothing before my reign ended. Look on them now.
I believe you wanted to help, but we were doomed the moment you came here. The Emperor will want to make an example of your resistance. He'll likely claim we conspired with you as an excuse to crack down harder.
Why are you being targeted by Arkan?
Because we doubt. Tell them the reason.
I asked for proof of how our immortal Emperor could ever die.
I searched the old ways for guidance.
I wondered why we continue to seek revenge on so many outlanders for the actions of one. I sought justice for those condemned to exile. We all had questions, and the new Emperor does not suffer them. You may have given him an excuse to silence us for good.
We have a camp. I can offer you protection.
You've suffered enough out here. We can help.
Okay. We'll trust you.
Kenner, we're on our way back. We've got civvies in tow. A lot of them. Be on the lookout. Hope you're up for some trailblazing. We'll need a clearer path for a group this large. Let's go!
Welcome back, sir. The refugees have been trickling in. We're setting them up where we can. But I'm concerned about supplies. This is a lot of mouths to feed.
Shelter and protection will have to do for now. We'll resume the mission tomorrow, after the refugees have settled in. Get some shut-eye.
Understood, sir. You heard him. Get this camp in order and tuck in.
This alliance may be your show to run, but those soldiers, they're my responsibility. We clear?
You take the whole galaxy's troubles on your shoulders if you could. I admire that.
Just doing the job I signed up for. I'll see you in the morning. 0700. You saved a lot of lives today.
Will he be joining us?
In an advisory capacity. Pashna knows more about Zakuul than all of us put together.
What you did yesterday? I wouldn't have thought it possible. I want to help you do more.
A source of mine in the SIS entrusted Havoc with an interesting piece of intelligence not too long ago. I'm guessing we have Theron to thank for that. But it's the reason we're all here.
No comment.
The data identified a planetary transmitter within a Zakuul night outpost. Our mission is to plant a wiretap on that equipment.
Knowing what Arkan's up to could open up a lot of opportunities.
We get a direct line on their communications. Havoc can start hitting high-value targets all across the Spire.
And evade retaliation.
We'd be ghosts.
Deadly. Heavily armed. Ghosts.
This sounds like something Havoc Squad could have accomplished already.
Deploying the wiretap without it being discovered will either take a month of prep or a really big distraction. If you're willing to commit the resources, we can move on this immediately.
Everything's shaping up like you planned, Theron?
Well...
straight answer.
The transmitter is a target we can hit, and Havoc are the right ones to hit it. The sooner the better.
Then it's decided. Send word to Odessen. We're going on the offensive.
You're really going to attack Arkan's forces?
Just enough to get their attention. We don't have the forces for a real invasion yet.
Your people can handle the diversion. I want you along for the strike on the transmitter. We're gonna need every heavy hitter we can get, and you more than qualify. Let's move out!
Thank you.
few sentries on the exterior. Nothing out of the ordinary. Give the order when ready.
Begin the attack.
Copy. Let's go!
I think that's the best we're gonna get. Havoc, keep us covered and watch for reinforcements. We're going in.
Copy, Major.
We need support!
Anyone listening out there? Mission team calling for reinforcements.
Falling back, but we're heavily engaged. You're gonna have to hold out.
We're on our own for now.
Damn!
You aren't kidding, sir. We've got contact from all directions.
Blast! The good news? It works.
And the bad?
They know we're here.
Reinforcements are already inbound. We've got incoming. Brace for a fight, Havoc.
How's it looking in there, sir? It's not pretty out here.
Form up on the main entrance. We're coming out.
We're seeing a lot of action in the south corner. It's like it's raining skytroopers.
We're boxed in. Can anyone support us?
Yeah, I got something for you.
Oh, you too, huh? Yeah!
We can take them! Come on!
Knights, leave them to me. Do not engage.
My team is taking some bad hits. We can't hold out for long.
We're suffering too many casualties. We need to pull out soon.
Any last words?
Can that garbage.
Had to be droids.
About damn time.
I thought we might not make it. I'm glad to be wrong.
That makes all of us.
When we heard your call, we knew what had to be done. We've spent our entire lives being protected by our droids, by you. We want to stand for ourselves.
Won't get any argument from me. Let's get back to camp, huh?
We took a beating, but the mission was a success. And we discovered an unexpected ally. I'd call that progress.
The Force was with us today.
Tell the Force to bring reinforcements.
It's a bigger victory for Pashna and his people than us. Finding the will to fight back, proving they could win.
Arkan seeming his own defeat in these swamps.
How do you mean?
Every defiant soul Arkan drives out here, we can turn into a weapon against him. I want to embed havoc with the Rebels.
Train them to be a proper fighting force. Build an army right under his nose.
Whip them into shape. I'll work on getting them equipment.
If we teach them right, you won't have to. Interesting group you've got here.
Takes all kinds, I guess.
Against this enemy, anyone we can find.
Desperation makes for strange bedfellows.
Not the strangest for some of us.
One more. Word.
Enough.
Fun as this is, I need to get back to Havoc. I've requisitioned passable training gear to issue to the Rebels. At least until they can keep from shooting their own toes off.
I can't believe we're gonna ask civilians to fight our battles. It doesn't feel right.
They're going to do this whether we help or not. Teaching them how to is what's best for them and us.
A more rigorous analysis would suggest the cost-benefit is more strictly in their favor.
I'm willing to make some sacrifices to help these people.
That is your foolish prerogative. I will attempt to compensate for it.
Pushy droid you've got.
You don't want to call her that.
What? Pushy?
Droid. The extent of my being is beyond your comprehension.
Yeah, clearly. If you need me, you know where to look.
I require your attention. Do not tarry.
Good. You're here.
Astute observation, Agent Shan. It is a wonder the SIS could get by without your deductive reasoning.
You're a droid that's gotten too big for her own bolts. How's that for an astute observation?
5 minutes. Can we please go 5 minutes without you two at each other's throats?
Scorpio, don't be rude. And Theron, you know better than to give in to her taunts.
Sorry. Stress got the better of me. Scorpio, show the commander what you found. Please.
My analysis of enemy communications obtained by Havoc Squad revealed something interesting. Hidden inside a mundane signal, I discovered encrypted transmissions codenamed the Gemini Frequency. They are broadcast from the throne to every vessel in the Eternal Fleet. The spire schematics provided by Kaleo confirm this.
It's how Arkan commands his warships. This is the break we've been waiting for, a direct line to the enemy fleet.
Start a plan of attack. It's Arkan's turn to be on the defensive.
Scorpio cross-referenced all the data Havoc Squad and Kaleo stole from Zakuul. When we compared the enemy's comm logs to the Spire maps, we found something unexpected. There's a hyperwave relay station hidden 10,000 meters beneath the Spire. It's the only source of Gemini frequency transmissions to and from the Eternal Throne.
I thought the Throne controlled the Eternal Fleet.
Broadcasting a signal to thousands of ships across the galaxy takes tremendous energy. The relay station's powered by 200 reactors tapping directly into Zakuul's planetary core.
That relay station is our key to the Gemini frequency. If we can decrypt it, we'll eavesdrop on the enemy and learn his plans.
We have a map. All we need is a route.
You'll never get near that relay station. It's 10 kilometers underground and defended by more safeguards than we can count.
That's a good thing our data reveals every security measure in the way, and how to defeat them.
A strike team can disable the defenses right under Arkan's nose, but only if we send it in now. Our intel's turning stale as we speak.
Kaleo and Major Jorgen are already on Zakuul. They're in position to clear the commander a path directly to the relay station.
We are not sending that terrorist. She's done enough to my world.
Senyu's right. Can't believe I had to say that.
Havoc Squad was made for this op. We have enough detonite to turn that relay station into a crater. Cut the head off the serpent. Throw the fleet into chaos.
You're trusting the fate of the galaxy to a gang of grenade-happy bucketheads? We're only getting one shot at this. Lucky for you, one shot is all I need.
Oh, is that what you tell all your victims?
Destroying that relay station is a bonehead play. Send me, and you'll control the Gemini frequency.
The idea has potential. And she's an experienced infiltrator who survived on Zakuul for years.
She bombed my people. Never again.
This alliance will never win if we can't function as a team. I need all of you to pull together and do what's necessary.
It's not that simple. We need to draw Arkan's attention away from our true goal. That means creating a diversion.
They're both accomplished at drawing attention. The real question is, who do you want with you at the relay station?
If we can't take control of the Gemini frequency, we'll have to destroy it. Havoc Squad has the firepower for that job.
Without me there to slice that relay station, Major Malfunction's suicide run will be a self-fulfilling prophecy. Give me a chance.
If you're so committed to not setting off bombs, who am I to argue? Major, I need you to provide our distraction.
That actually worked, huh? This might be fun.
I hope you know what you're doing, Commander.
You can't please everyone. But it may be prudent to consult Valkorion. He built the Spire. He may tell you how to invade it.
Valkorion, we need to talk.
Jedi and their consultations. In too many ways, you remain bound to that order. You took my power, and now come for my secrets. But you have not earned them.
You always knew what controlled the Eternal Fleet. You should have told me.
I am not your servant, and you have trifled with my patience for the last time.
Theron, it's me. Something's wrong. I need backup.
Your friends cannot hear you.
You brought me here. Why?
Sometimes, evolution requires a push or a sacrifice. You have forgotten what it means to face death alone. I will remind you. A path has been laid before you, but you refuse to tread upon it. That will change. Can you sense the predators closing in? They smell your weakness. They would feast on it. You have a destiny to fulfill. I am tired of being disappointed by your lack of progress. My son blindsided me because I allowed it, but you were weak. My son struck a killing blow against you. Had I not interfered, you would be dead. Perhaps I should have let you go then. The galaxy is finally united under a single banner. It should have been yours. Despite your precious warship, a legion of allies, and my immense power at your disposal, you remain incomplete. The Force is with you, Jedi, but it will not defeat my son. It never could. Until you embrace your full potential, you will only be a pawn of fate, never its master.
I follow my own path, Valkorion, not yours.
You truly believe that? How pathetic. The future is not a river to carry us. It is the ocean in which we drown if we are not prepared. You have two destinies, Outlander. In one, you defeat Arkon, claim the Eternal Throne, and remake the galaxy. In the other, you die alone, unmourned and forgotten. I brought you here to taste that defeat. Pitiful. Why did I ever believe you could change anything?
You have no idea what I'm capable of.
And neither do you. Therein lies the problem. This was a fraction of the pain my children can inflict. If you do not finish your training, become something greater, you will feel the full weight of their rage.
You act like I didn't leave Tython as a fully trained Jedi.
You do not perceive the path ahead, even when it is obvious. Let that be your first lesson. I cannot stay to protect you any longer. There are matters to which I must attend. But I will leave you with a final token of my favor. Fulfill your destiny, and I promise to return.
You can exist outside my head? Where are you going, and why?
It is pointless to explain. You will understand when the time comes.
Cheer up, big brother. You're making me sad.
Father won't face me himself.
He's punishing you for stealing his chair.
He isn't angry. Father never feels anything. Not even when I... when Vexen died.
He was a good brother. Brought me gifts from all the worlds he conquered.
I freed you from Father's control. I hope that earned your support.
My loyalties lie here, Arkon. Always. Now what?
For millennia, Jedi and Sith archive their knowledge in holocrons. These legacies preserve the wisdom of great minds. The focus was often on exploring mysteries of the Force, not the practical matters of government. After all, Jedi do not seek to lead, and it is in the nature of Sith to force their wills upon others. But a few sought to understand what it truly means to lead a civilization. These are their teachings. I've waited for you a long time. welcome to my home, Outlander.
Jedi Master Satil Shan. When Valkorion told me to finish my training, he meant with you?
You're asking the wrong person. Yes, I'm going to offer a meal. Stop rushing me. You survived an ordeal. Come. Sit. There's food.
I was brought here against my will. People are counting on me for help. I have to go.
People are always counting on you. They won't stop just because you aren't there. Many things changed while you slept in Carbonite. I led the fight to save the Republic from Zakul. Nothing prepared me to face that enemy. I failed. Again and again.
This camp isn't new. You've been on Odessen for a while.
When the Republic surrendered to Arkan, I gave myself to the will of the Force. I left the Core Worlds and found this planet. We've been here for years, waiting.
We? Is there someone else here?
In the Force, we are never alone. We sensed your awakening on Zakul. Felt the presence of our old enemy guiding you. We witnessed the victories and defeats leading you here. When we found you in that clearing, we faced a choice. Bring you here, or end you there.
I don't think your son would appreciate it if you killed me.
We didn't save you to spare Theron's feelings. We felt something we'd lost for a long time. Hope. Valkorion strengthened your bond to the Force. You may be the greatest of us all, but your old training couldn't prepare you for what's to come. You have much to learn. Follow us. Seek the answers throughout the valley. You will know when you find them. The most powerful among us couldn't stand against the endless legions of Zakul. Even the Sith Empire learned that lesson too late. On countless worlds, I watched Jedi sacrifice themselves to delay inevitable defeat. We will not let you meet their fate. I went to Zakul in secret to see the Eternal Throne myself. I still bear the scars of that journey. There is no greater challenge than to change from within. But that is what we all must do to survive. On Odessen, light and dark exist in perfect balance, forming a nexus in the Force. There is another world like it, Zakul. Arkan and his knights learned to use the Force in a different way from Jedi and Sith. It's why we couldn't truly defeat them.
What makes Arkan and his followers so different from Jedi or Sith?
Jedi approach the Force as a companion, and Sith try to enslave it. But Arkan's knights believe the Force is their reward for serving an ideal. They swear their lives to the Eternal Emperor. The more they honor his commandments, the greater their power. The knights obey their master without question, sacrificing everything for his triumph. Devotion makes them strong. You must become stronger.
Master Satil, that goes against everything you ever taught me. It's the kind of thing Valkorion would say.
We are nothing like that man.
Darth Maar.
Valkorion destroyed my flesh, but not my reason for being.
Is defeating your old master so important that you refuse to die?
I have no use for vengeance. My goal remains the same. Defend the Empire. After my defeat, I sought an ally to make things right again. But only one in all the galaxy was my equal. We met on this world. We argued, explored, and found an understanding. We now pass that knowledge to you.
If Jedi and Sith have found a way to work together, I want to know how.
No one is more surprised than I am to be here in this moment. But I trust the will of the Force.
We do not offer empty platitudes. We do not promise easy victory.
All we ask is that you listen with an open mind, and learn from our failures.
To forge the future, you must first break with the past. Victory over Arkhan requires new perspectives. And new weapons.
Follow the will of the Force into the wilderness beyond this camp. Find what we left for you, and meet us in the cave.
Arkhan won't be conquered through passion or righteousness. He has emptied himself of weaknesses, like sentiment and morality.
It will not be enough to defeat Arkhan. His eternal throne and the fleeted commands are the greatest threats our galaxy has ever faced.
Your enemy stole his empire through deceit and murder. He's accustomed to the dark. You must strike where he's blind, from within. The Sith Code teaches us to break our chains, but freedom is not your ultimate goal. You must anchor yourself to power. When Arkhan lies defeated, your destiny is to take the Eternal Throne. Any other path will lead only into chaos.
The Force is in motion, and we must follow. The old ways aren't enough. We'll show you the new way.
In life, I dismissed the Jedi Code. I was wrong. There is no death. There is only the Force. And it has a plan. The will of the Force is a flowing current. You can follow or fight it, but it is always there.
Tick tock, tick tock, tick tock. Tell me, do you believe in the future?
I have a future, Valen, but you don't.
Just the way I like it.
Again, every time you close your eyes.
Fought Arkhan's sister. Valen was right here.
No. That was merely a warning, a vision. A bond to the Force as intense as yours brings with it powerful insight.
Heed what you saw. Behind Arkhan stands Valen, and behind her, many others. They will all try to stop you. The weapon you wield was built for a different war, a different enemy. It no longer serves you. It must change, as you have.
You want me to build a new lightsaber?
You will create a pure extension of the Force's will. One you alone control. With it, you can unite 1,000 stars.
We offer to add our strength to yours, but you must be the guiding hand. Focus the power, and decide what form it takes.
I'm ready when you are. There's no defeat I can't overcome. It's done.
That blade is part of you now. The next time you face Arkhan in battle, he will not be ready for you.
But violence can only destroy. It doesn't inspire others to greatness, and it can never rebuild. Only a leader can do that.
I once thought it enough to be the unstoppable force between my people and the enemy. I faced Valkorion and refused to bend. That choice broke me and doomed the worlds I sought to defend.
I sent Jedi to fight an enemy I didn't understand because I believed in the justness of my cause. Those deaths still haunt me. We know what it means to fail those who counted on us. We would spare you that pain.
It's better for me to learn from your mistakes than repeat them.
Your brief time as the Supreme Commander of Jedi Forces on Corellia tested you and exposed your limitations.
Leading this alliance is unlike anything you have done before. Directing the war effort is a mere fraction of the burden you must bear.
You must not only know when to fight, but when to retreat, or even to make peace with your foe. There is an oasis not far from this cave. Your final lesson waits there.
Forget what your old masters taught you. Not even Valkorion understands. The Force is not an ally, slave, or transaction. The Force is a paradox. It empowers and imprisons. It destroys and unites. It binds the galaxy together and tears people apart. It has a will, but needs a commander.
You killed her children. She will devour you as revenge.
What hope do you have to escape such raw fury?
Escape isn't always possible. If you accept that death has power over you, it stops being your enemy and becomes an ally. When that happens, you don't have to fight.
You created peace from a violent confrontation. Impressive. Some believe you're destined to walk this path. Others think you make the choices that decide their fates.
Your alliance will collapse if you do not know yourself and the ideal you serve. Do you understand?
Whatever fate has in store for me in the alliance, I'm ready.
Your way is clear, and so is ours. Do you feel it, Mar? The Force draws us elsewhere.
The exile on Odessen is over.
A new path has opened, thanks to you. Our duty is to follow it.
You can't leave. You've barely told me anything I need to know.
You know what must be done. That's enough. Trust in the path ahead. The Alliance awaits its commander. Farewell.
Sub-level 4 open. No guards. So close to a new kill record.
We should have canceled her mission when the commander disappeared. She's unstable.
She's ahead of schedule, and the casualties are acceptable.
So glad to have your support.
The relay station is only 3 levels away. Be prepared to slice the Gemini frequency the moment you're inside.
She terrorized our home, and we let her go back.
It's not too late for Piasecka-Jarzabek to finish this op right. Demolish the whole facility.
Over your dead body.
Or yours. Let's not be picky.
If I were an assassin droid, you'd all be dead.
Where the blazes have you been?
Valkorion dragged me into the wilderness and almost killed me. Then he left my mind to go somewhere else. He wouldn't say. I found Satil Shan with the spirit of Darth Maar. They helped me build a new lightsaber to defeat Arkan. They're a team now, following the will of the Force.
That's an awful lie. It must be true.
Blast it. Skytroopers. At least a dozen. Almost ran right into them.
Don't panic. Maybe they didn't see you.
If they did, things are about to get exciting.
Kaleo, come in. Come in. No signal.
We need a contingency plan. If they capture her, turn her against us?
We can't evacuate Odessa. We just finished decorating the place.
I warned you this would happen. We're going in.
Kaleo had her chance. It's your turn, Major.
We won't let you down, Commander. Havoc Squad, move out!
Still no word from Major Jorgen or Kaleo.
Everything within a kilometer of the spire has been locked down. No signal gets in or out of that zone.
I warned you that Gemini frequency mission was dangerous. If they're alive, it won't be for much longer.
The gravestone could take the enemy by surprise. Buy me enough time to get our people out of the spire.
Whoa. We can't throw the gravestone into the fire unless we know they're alive to rescue.
Too much remains unknown. And the enemy has had time to prepare its defense. We cannot risk any rescue operation.
I'll alert you the moment I hear anything, but until then, we're just wasting time here.
We could all use a break to regroup. That includes you, Theron.
I'm too tired to argue. Oh, almost forgot. Hilo Viz asked to see you, Commander. Wouldn't say why, but it sounded important.
Commander, got a sec?
What's on your mind?
We're doing our best to keep the supply lines running, but most of the people I deal with aren't exactly philanthropists. We can't keep running this thing on goodwill and borrowed credits.
You're saying we need a steady income.
Or a really big slush fund. But look, I didn't just come here with complaints. I know a guy with a habit of showing up when someone's in need. He's reached out with an offer we can't really refuse, much as I might want to. You should meet him.
So, he's what? A loan shark?
No, just a liar. And a cheat. And a thief. The only thing to trust about him is that he can do what he promises. Hear him out. Come on.
Well, this has been an interesting diversion, but I think it's time to wrap things up. I call.
Come on, Lana. Now? My fold.
So soon? Must be quite a hand. Let's see it.
But
You discarded every chance you got and never locked a card the whole round. The odds are astronomical. You cheated.
Yeah, even if I did, you sure the old boss of Sith Intelligence wants to admit some shifty alien got the better of her?
Wasted no time turning the card table into a graveyard.
It's my preferred method of execution.
Commander, the most untrustworthy scoundrel I know. Untrustworthy scoundrel, the Commander.
She never was big on formalities. Galt Renault, at your service.
How is it you two know each other exactly?
Oh, we go way back.
I don't know. Seems like only yesterday that we first met.
Anyway, we really should get on to business. The Eternal Empire spent the last 5 years pillaging every world in the known galaxy. Now, how'd you like to turn all that plundering into a profit for you and yours?
I'm listening.
I happen to know where they're keeping all that ill-gotten gain. Better yet, I've got a surefire plan to steal it right out from under their noses. I just need the help of a few talented, tough customers to see it through.
Stealing for financial gain doesn't generally sit right with me.
Think of it as the rightful reclamation of wealth stolen by Arkan in the first place. You'd be striking a real blow to his war effort. Ever heard of the Gilded Star? I'll stop you there. You haven't. It's one of the Eternal Empire's most tightly guarded secrets. A floating treasury circling the depths of a massive gas giant. The ship and the buried treasure all wrapped up into one neat little package. Well, maybe not little. By my estimation, it's the greatest sum of wealth gathered in one place since the Hutt Empire was a thing. So, you in?
I don't think I need any more reasons to say yes.
I hoped you'd feel that way. When you're ready to get this show on the road, we'll be heading to Vanden to lay some groundwork. Looking forward to this, partner. There she is, Vanden. Mind the ledges when you're walking around unless you fancy a death by scenic view.
You haven't mentioned why we're here.
Giant barge full of money. Is this ringing any bells? It's out there somewhere, swimming below sight and scan range. Something about the magnetism here plays havoc with sensors and cheap fillings. Bottom line is, we'll never find the Gilded Star out there, which is all the more reason to get our preparations underway. Such as picking up the last member of our illustrious crew.
How many people are we going to need?
Half a dozen, give or take. This is the last one unaccounted for. You should be in a warehouse, not far from the dockyards. I'll point out the place when I see it. This is the place. Ah, that container over there. So, this plan I mentioned? It's going to take the best identity forger this side of the galaxy to pull off. Problem is, he's been in hiding, specifically in that, for a long time. He probably won't be too thrilled to have visitors. Especially not visitors who had his safe house shipped a few thousand parsecs unannounced. Be on your toes.
So you kidnapped him?
That's more of a change of address. stretcher, is it? They always say retirement's a good time to travel. Why don't you come and check out the new scenery?
Tiresias, you've got a lot of nerve showing your ugly mug to me again.
Tiresias?
Just a name I carried around for a while, no use to anybody now. I think you've got me confused for someone else, friend. Name's Galt Renault. Got a business proposition I think you'll want to hear about.
You can't play dumb with me, Ty. I know that face better than you do.
Galt tells me you're the best identity forger in the business. We could use you.
I've had enough of helping that fraud fake his own death. This time, it's gonna stick. A little gift for your hospitality. You can mail order just about anything these days.
Still can't roll with the punches. You perfectionist types never learn. There's no such thing as a sure thing.
Why are we trying to recruit someone who wants to kill you?
He's the one with the crotch! After I made that body double, he went and swindled half of Nar Shaddaa in my name!
Because Dretcher is literally the only one I trust to pull this off.
It's taken everything I know to stay hidden in this little prison. Every time I start to think I can leave, someone snitches on my new identities.
That true?
So maybe I encourage Dretcher's early retirement. This little box is cozier than a coffin and a better place to reflect on how stupid trying to blackmail me was. But hey, ancient history, am I right? I'm more than willing to forget about our past disagreements if you do one more job for me.
I can never help you again.
Listen, Dretcher. I don't know how much you know about life on the outside these days, but it's bad.
If you want there to be something left to look forward to when you come out, I need your help.
And if you think it's hard to live under the scanners now, just wait until the Eternal Empire's fully staked their claim on the galaxy. Sit tight, Dretch, and get reacquainted with the concept of hygiene. We've got one more stop to make before we get to the fun part. Punctual, gentlemen. Glad you could make it all this way. No trouble acquiring my little request, I take.
It's here. You got our money?
Of course, friend, but I'd be remiss if I didn't ask to see the goods first.
Satisfied.
I think you need to tell me more about this plan.
We're getting to that part just as soon as we're finished here.
You got our money?
About that. I was really thinking we should renegotiate the price. You know, seeing as I don't need the whole missile. Yeah, I thought you might feel that way.
Launch sequence initiated. Target acquired.
total atomic dispersal in T-minus 1 minute.
You son of a... Make it stop!
Nah.
Hope you're a good runner.
Jumping might be faster.
T-minus 55 seconds. Warhead primed. Suffering index set to maximum.
You're gonna pay for this!
Suckers.
Abort sequence aborted. No stopping me now!
Yeah, what did she do to this thing? Come on, it's not responding!
Are there any circuits you could cut?
Oh sure, dozens. Got any ideas which ones?
Tampering detected. Emergency detonation in 5 seconds. Nice try, jerks.
Now, I cannot tell if she did a terrible job rewiring this or too good a one.
Three. Oh, so close. Two. I can't wait. One.
Kaboom! That was great.
Ha, ha.
Come on, that was pretty good. Admit it. As pranks go, high marks.
Don't encourage her. Allow me to introduce my partner, Vet. She has a habit of getting where she's not wanted. Like on your nerves, for instance. Did you get the warhead, or were you too busy practicing your lines?
Yes, I got it, Grumpy Pants.
Though I guess those lizard brains will have figured out nothing's exploded by now. I'll see if I can't distract them.
Time to make ourselves scarce. We'll see you back at the hideout.
Toodles.
If you're still wondering why you're here, it isn't to check out the Tabana gas bars. There's a stealth cruiser loaded with more precious metals than a Hutt's taste in art hiding down in the lower atmosphere, and it's about to come up for air.
And while the Gilded Star is roosting at the Skyhook for its annual resupply, we're going to rob it blind.
How do you even know about that?
A little bird told us. I speak stool pigeon.
Even if you do know where it's going to be, it's got a full military complement on board. And a vault that could survive the ship being reduced to atoms.
Most people would consider it impregnable, but we aren't most people, are we, Senya?
You do seem to know a lot about our target.
Yes, well, I should. Overseeing the Gilded Star was among my duties when I still served Valkorion.
Then you are privy to its operational protocols.
I doubt they're still the same.
You don't have to run the thing. Just get Scorpio to the ship's control center.
There's no way we could infiltrate that far into the ship undetected.
Maybe, maybe not. But I'm pretty sure High Justice Valen can go wherever she pleases.
You're going to have Senya pose as Valen.
We've got the best identity doctor this side of the galaxy, and as close to a genetic match as we're gonna get.
I could never match Valen's gene sequence like that. Although, maybe simulating data corruption in her ID.
And create enough doubt to bluff her way through. Dear old mom can manage that, right? Once Valen and her attaché droid are on board, they head to the bridge, seize control of the ship, and allow the rest of us to do our parts.
Like cracking the vault. It isn't controlled by the network, so I've got to get into the guts of the ship to reach the mechanism. I'll need your help.
Meanwhile, Lana and Koth will bridge airlocks with a tanker transport I've secured for the goods.
How are we going to carry an entire treasury's worth of loot out of the vault before anyone catches on?
Oh, we won't be carrying anything out of the vault. Into, that's another story. Remember how Senya mentioned the vault could withstand everything outside being vaporized? Same applies to what we're setting off inside.
The warhead.
Exactly. I'll be pulling up the rear with a disintegration bomb. Once it's done its job, we pump the atmosphere into the waiting tanker and make our escape.
What's the exit strategy?
Once that sucker explodes, the crew's going to notice. Everybody's just going to have to hightail it to the transport before they catch on.
Now, since we've got less than a day before the Gilded Star rolls into port, I'd suggest everybody get real familiar with their part. This is close enough. And there's the Gilded Star, just like I promised.
I was expecting shinier.
Gold-plated and stealth ship don't exactly line up. Now, we just have to hope Mommy Dearest remembers her daughter's birthday.
I can kill you from here, Gold.
Great, really getting into the spirit of your character, at least from what I hear.
Shut up.
We are approaching the checkpoint. No further communications are warranted until the bridge is under our control.
Roger, break a leg, ladies. It's in their hands now. All we've got to do is wait.
Once they open the way for us, all we have to do is get this bomb inside the vault?
Assuming everything goes according to plan. But hey, if something has to go horribly wrong, now's the best time, for us anyway.
I honestly can't tell if that's optimism.
Oh sure, I'd be less than thrilled to have my perfect shot at ludicrous affluence botched by rank amateurs, but live to filch another day and all that.
I am now in complete control of the Gilded Star's network. I will isolate the vessel's sentinels to the best of this system's ability.
Showtime!
Okay, I ought to be able to reach the vault mechanism along this route. Keep clearing a path for Galt, and I'll see you soon.
I really, really hope they check for Minox.
Are you sure those schematics were scaled in meters? I can hardly move.
My last partner didn't complain nearly this much.
Your last partner was crushed to death.
And never once complained about it. Okay, Vet, I'm here.
Just give me a sec.
Time's a factor.
Hey, you want to cut through a foot of cortosis and steel while hanging upside down in a half-meter crawl space? There. Jerk. Try it. The moment of truth.
I've been rich, filthy rich, but nothing like this. Counting the zeros on a balance sheet can't even compare. There's just something magical about the real thing.
I couldn't begin to put a number to all this.
At a certain point, you just stop counting. It won't look nearly as impressive in a second, but it'll spend all the same. Do the honors?
For the Alliance and freedom.
It's time for the pay dirt.
We're in position. Extending umbilical. Seal is tight. All green.
Airlock disengaged. Awaiting order for depressurization.
Door is open!
Commencing depressurization.
Tank is filling.
So far, so good.
It will take approximately 10 minutes, 17 seconds to siphon a space of that volume.
Plenty of time to make our exit.
Great. Let's blow this joint.
Did you bring that with you?
This little thing? Nah. I passed the armory and it was just laying around, so I figured nobody'd miss it.
It is unlikely the detonation went unnoticed. After we vacate the bridge, I will no longer be able to maintain a complete lockdown.
See? perfectly justified acquisition. Come on, I want to try this thing out.
Just scramble the systems as best you can and leg it to the tanker. We'll see you there.
We're at capacity. Scorpio and Senya are on board. What's the situation?
We're keeping them busy on our end, but I don't think we're any closer to reaching you. Scorpio, do you still have any access to the blast doors?
Only through direct input.
Great. Just bug out before anyone notices you buzzing around. We'll take the skyhook back down and meet you at the hideout. Play it cool. My guardian angel will handle anybody taking an unhealthy interest. Oh, boy.
The lift's not coming, is it?
Oh, no, it's coming. It's just not empty.
Valen. I can sense her presence.
Time for Plan B.
What's Plan B?
Run and hope for a Plan C.
I was expecting something a bit more concrete.
There's being prepared and being psychic. For lack of a crystal ball, we'll have to improvise. Even if you win and don't turn the skyhook into crumbled wreckage, we'll still be surrounded by thousands of her flunkies. We have to go around.
There is no around.
There is out there.
You want us to scale the exterior?
Pretty much. Look, there's no time to stand here arguing, so I recommend lodging your complaints at a steady jog.
It's not so bad. Just don't look down. Or consider your own mortality. Goodbye, Spewy. I'll never forget you.
Hey, so just thinking of you, wanted to say... Trouble? No, everything's going great. Just taking a little detour on the way home.
Golf?
Shh! The noise? Just a little windy is all. What plan am I on? Plan C. We're on Plan C, all right? Yeah, sounds lovely. Gotta go, see you soon. The good news is we can reach the skyhook from here.
And the bad?
If you've got a fear of heights, there will be plenty of time to get over it on the way down. Okay, so, remember Plan C?
You never actually got to Plan C, Galt.
Turns out Plan C is... jump!
Mother was here, again. She had the audacity to wear my face.
And a punishment.
Escaped. She knows I won't be bested the next time we meet.
Ah, empty threats all you've brought for me.
I interrupted their little raid on the treasury. They couldn't have accomplished much in the time they were here.
Perfect timing.
I'm not the one who has a problem showing up when I'm supposed to.
Jeez, how long are you planning to hold that over me?
The rest of your life, naturally. Thanks for keeping my worst half out of too much trouble.
You two are a couple?
Don't sound so surprised.
It's complicated.
Anyway, I think we've all had our fill of Vanden, and it's gonna get a lot less hospitable shortly, so... shall we?
Let's get our haul back to Audessen.
There's nothing like coming home from a job well done, especially when you've ruined a huge jerk's day in the process.
couldn't agree more. Come to think of it, our plan was lacking in one department.
An actual escape route?
It was the scenic route. Can't argue with the view. No, the one thing missing was a way to see the look on Arkan's face when he got the news.
Oh, I hope it has an effect on more than his ego.
I wouldn't expect an overnight collapse, but when His Highness's checks start bouncing, it'll shake things up. Count on that. Now, how about we get on with my favorite part and divvy up the loot?
Already taken care of. You, Vet, and Dretch are already paid out. I took the liberty of skimming what you owe me off yours.
Well, take all the fun out of it, why don't you?
Your idea of fun is why your divvying privileges are still revoked.
Just what did you do exactly?
Ran out on me with the biggest score of our careers.
And I regretted it ever since. Well, after the shine wore off. A little older, a little wiser, you know? Okay, maybe a lot older. It was a formative moment. The point is we're on to bigger and better things. Like melting a mint down into an ocean of liquid happiness. Now, however you want to spend your cut is none of my business. But if you want to, say, triple it, I might have a little something in the works.
This money isn't ours. I don't mind taking it from Arkan. But I want nothing to do with it.
It does feel wrong to keep it.
Our goal was to fund the Alliance, not personal gain.
Who says it can't be both? You just need a little ambition.
Or, you know, you could try giving. Maybe just once. See what you've been missing. My share is going towards buying back some of the artifacts stolen from my people. Freeing slaves. Giving Twi'lax a better place in the galaxy.
Honestly, we've got way more than we need for operations. It'd be good to have a plan for the excess.
I'd like to distribute our surplus back to the worlds Arkan plundered. I don't care how.
A fruitless gesture. That wealth will return to the Eternal Empire so long as they remain in power.
People are suffering out there. What are we doing if not trying to help them?
If you are confused, our objective is not to alleviate suffering. It is removing the Eternal Empire from power.
No fools in accounting, and no accounting for fools.
It appears our business is concluded.
Oh, I don't know. I figure you'll be seeing me around. You've got a handy little outfit here. Besides, I wouldn't want Hilo to get lonely.
As if.
If your Alliance happens to need a morale officer, I'm game. Kicking Arkan's butt should require a full-time party planner.
Speaking of parties... This stuff sells for more than most freighters. Grab some glasses and get to know what success tastes like.
Commander, Major Jorgen and Kaleo just landed. They're in the docking bay.
So much for celebrating. Go ahead, we'll be right behind.
I was 30 meters from a computer that would have given me the Gemini frequency. But no, your idiot brigade had to come in blasting.
You were surrounded. We saved you.
And blew the mission. If it wasn't for my backup plan, you would have died down there.
Backup plan? Your escape route detonated in a hospital.
You blew up a hospital getting off Sakul?
How was I supposed to know what was on the other side of that wall? You expect me to knock? It wasn't a complete loss. I grabbed something on the way out.
My fire team covered you.
Yeah, yeah. Point is, we lifted the data core from a security console right outside that hyperwave relay station. It's not the key to the Gemini frequency, but it does contain a massive file archive all about those droids.
I'll put Scorpio to work sifting through the information. See if there's anything to salvage from this fiasco.
Whatever's in those files has to make up for the lives that were lost getting them.
Nobody regrets those losses more than me, Commander. The casualties were unacceptable.
It could have gone much worse, but we can't let this happen again. Commander, I recommend these operatives be confined to base for the time being.
What? Forget that!
No, he's right. We didn't function like a team and other people paid with their lives.
No one needs to be punished. I was supposed to lead the mission. If I had, maybe none of this would have happened.
That's an excellent point. I'm just saying we skip the moping and get back to winning the war.
Remember why we fight, and don't forget this failure. Dismissed.
I'll start with her fingertips, and work my way up. Take one knuckle at a time, then her hands.
Do you remember, Mother? Not what she is now. Who are the children?
I remember her telling Father I was dangerous. How I had to be controlled. She always hated me.
She never understood us. Oh, Father.
She helped the Outlander steal Alfredi's. They took everything.
Those things can be replaced.
When all the worlds we've conquered find out what's happened, they'll think we're weak. Test us.
I remain the greatest power the galaxy has ever seen. My enemies know what I'll do to them if they cross me.
Fear is always free.
I will be generous with it.
Master Jedi, we're ready.
Where are the others?
Theron is online from the Mistani sector. The rest are unavailable, on scouting or security detail.
I'd prefer to be patrolling myself. Can we proceed?
I have additional information regarding the Gemini network that controls the Eternal Fleet. The network links mechanical captains inside the fleet's ships. Their security protocols cannot be directly subverted.
Why not?
Because the Gemini captains are based on me.
You said Zakuul took something from you. This is what you meant. This is what you've been looking for.
My suspicions about Gemini brought me to Zakuul. Now they are confirmed. I will not be imitated. And I will determine who is responsible. Based on what I have decoded, the Geminis are produced from a mold. A template. Gemini Prime.
Why a physical template?
My technology is not easily duplicated. The Gemini Prime is linked to a factory on the world of Darvanus. Retrieve the unit and I will unlock the secrets of the network and the fleet.
We get the Eternal Fleet, and you find out who's been copying you and how. Is that the deal?
Yes.
I know Darvanus. One of the first worlds we conquered when the war started. A staging point into the wider galaxy. That factory builds droids, weapons, starships. It's a key resource, fortified accordingly, fully automated defenses.
I've seen its like, tunnels running kilometers deep, too large for a strike team.
Then we plan a full-scale assault. How close are we to assembling an army?
We don't have nearly enough people here. But Theron...
I've been securing military allies along the rim. There's a favor I can pull in. Rather not say more over the comm, but I can set a rendezvous with forces on Darvanus. You can take the factory and grab Gemini.
It's been a while since I led troops into battle, but that's the burden of a Jedi in wartime.
I'll signal our allies. Any luck, they'll be on Darvanus before you.
The rest of you, get the gravestone ready for combat. Once we have Gemini Prime, it'll be us against the fleet, one way or another.
you're on the wrong planet. The hot pleasure worlds are a dozen parsecs out.
Shut up, Como. You're in good shape for a dead woman.
Shay Vizsla. I wasn't expecting Mandalorians.
We're what you got. Heard you need a factory pulverized.
A dozen clans stand with Mandalore the Avenger. We're ready for blood, even if our enemies are built of metal and grease.
Mandalore the Avenger?
Rough few years. Eternal fleets kept us under siege on the Heartworlds. I picked up the title along the way. When your spy boy offered a chance to hit back, I agreed. Been on defense too long.
Then we fight together, Mandalore. Against Sakul and the galaxy. We'll topple Arkan yet.
Right now, I'd settle for one good victory.
How have you deployed your troops around the factory?
Rotating assault teams of 200 commandos each. Place is a fortress. Needs hammering before we go in.
Next attack starts in 5. Forward teams are in position to down the energy shield.
You want to be useful? Capture the perimeter guns and retarget the factory. Torian!
Mandalore.
Torian's chief of Clan Gadara, and the best scout we've got. He'll show you the way.
Guns are in Sector 9. Plenty of skytroopers. Keep up. I'll try to protect you.
Take me to the guns. We have a factory to conquer.
Retercia me, Mandalore.
Stay alive. Both of you.
To scrap in Sector 4.
Clan Chorn forces at the outer shield perimeter.
Is there no end to these abominable machines?
Ha! We are their end! Ashar and a dozen others are dead, but we've reached the shield generators.
Then maybe Torian and our new ally should stop dawdling, eh?
Dead.
Resembles a junkyard. Torn, the generators.
Detonation in 10 seconds. The shields will go down.
Maybe Torian will bother to take advantage of it.
Guns hot. Ready to target droids and factory defenses.
We have the shield generators down. Give the place a pounding.
Where are you?
Still inside the perimeter. The droids, they outflanked us. Couldn't withdraw.
Understood.
Those soldiers, they're inside the firing zone?
Yes, already dead. No honor in being beaten by machines.
I don't care about their honor, and they're not dead yet. Retarget the guns. Try to give them an escape route.
Your command, not mine.
Artillery team, what are you doing?
Chance for redemption. Suggest you withdraw. Better get back to base. Mandalore will be planning a new assault.
Look at all the silly Mandalorians running for their lives. Oh, that one didn't make it.
They crushed themselves against us without remorse.
You admire them?
They amuse me.
Are you smiling? I can never tell. We must answer this insult to the Eternal Empire, of course. Have the fleet burn them all to glass. We'll make a window from their remains. It'll be so pretty.
Darvanas can defend itself. All we have to do is watch the Mandalorians die.
You're the Emperor.
Severe damage to the inner ring of factory defenses. Plus, those shields are down.
And our losses?
28 seasoned Mandalorian warriors. But how they took their foes with them. 1,000 mindless programmed machines lie in the dirt today. Oh, future generations will sing songs of our brother's sacrifice against the spawn of Production Line 15 Alpha.
They're dead. No point mocking them.
Except they're not all dead, because you didn't concentrate your firepower. We'll pay for that tomorrow.
Since when is it dishonorable for a Mandalorian to be beaten by a droid? I've seen clans fight machines before.
Not like this. Not for years running.
No disgrace in dying to a droid. No disgrace in falling off a cliff either. But we're Mandalorians, bred for true combat.
We'll talk in the morning. Figure our next move when the troops are fresh.
For tonight, we celebrate survival. Show us how an Aruti like you handles Mandalorian drink.
Rough battle, probably a rough party. Not many outsiders celebrate with us.
If we're fighting together, I should know who you are. Taurian, leader of Clan Kadera. What does that mean?
Means I'm the last here. Were many of us before Zakul. Fewer since. I don't mind a good fight. Struggle, honor, pretty much the same. But I'm tired of friends dying.
We send Clan Baroya after the North Power Station and Fett to the south. That'll weaken the Skytroopers for the final push.
That should work if your troops are up to the task.
Power stations? What I'd give for a Republic barracks to bomb.
Eren's sniper units at the Zakul tactical post will outmaneuver the clans.
Show me the location. I'll handle the droids and give you time to reach the power stations.
You are going to hold off a battalion on your own. You're bold for an outsider, but not right.
We win this, we march inside next. Good hunting.
All right, you pathetic excuses for warriors! 3 barrels of spiced tea har to anyone who scraps more droids than Clan Fett!
A fool's bargain. You drank the last of the tea har last
Take
night.
All the more reason to try it best at!
Keep talking, and even the newcomer will beat you.
Yenko Far and his 3 sisters are dead.
Stranger, tell us you've kept the reinforcements at bay.
The droids are contained. Keep fighting.
Keep fighting? What else is there?
You shut down the sensors. I'll watch your back.
Lana, what is it?
I have a surprise.
Schematics for the Davanis factory procured by Theron. They're patchy, but they should help you and the Mandalorians concoct a battle plan.
Good. I should have Gemini Prime soon. Anything else?
One delicate matter. The Mandalorians make fierce allies, but I have certain concerns. Despite their code of honor, the clans have always had animalistic tendencies towards violence. I fear our arrangement may not last.
Treat the Mandalorians with respect, you'll get respect in return. I've spent enough time with them to see that.
I don't mean to say they'll plot against us. But in the long term, the clans have opposed both Republic and Empire in the past, raided planets for sport. Now imagine them free after Zakuul is beaten. Predators are beautiful, but they mustn't overrun an ecosystem. I trust you'll do what's right to hold our friends in check.
They level 1,000 guns against us, and still we endure. Ha!
Well done, all of you. We'll head into the factory within the hour.
There's a droid, Gemini Prime, linked to its machinery somewhere. It's key to beating the Eternal Fleet.
Take your droid, so long as we climb the weapons. Imagine the clans rearmed with the spoils of Darvenis, led by a new Mandalore. We'll break the siege of our homeworlds and smash Zakuul like in the days of the Neo-Crusaders.
The Mandalorian Neo-Crusaders were beaten by the Republic.
But they left scars, and they survived.
Dream of glory another time. Go, prepare the clans. One commander to another? Half the time, I feel like I'm making calls just to keep my people together.
At least all your troops are Mandalorians. I'm dealing with a more diverse coalition.
You're funny. Didn't think you'd be funny. Guess this is what happens when they put loners in charge. Come on, I'll show you the battle plan. Torian can stay with you. Get you to your droid while we smash the defenses and loot the armories. Wish we had more detailed scans, though. In those tight corridors, it could easily end up a slaughter.
One of my agents sent factory schematics a short while ago. It should give your troops an edge.
It's a blasted lot better than nothing. All right, then. Mandalorians, prepare for battle. There's no vengeance to be found today. No droid is worth an honor killing. But we fight because we're promised a shot at the enemy fleet. We fight to claim weapons for our war. Today we march. We bleed, exhaust ourselves, and die. Because our true destination will be a battle worth winning. Follow this outsider who fights among us, and seize victory!
You may not be one of us, but today, the Vanguard is yours.
Report in, Verda.
On our way to the armory. Enemy sick.
Security office is well guarded.
Still doomed.
Ion bombs are ready. We'll demolish their assault force.
Looks like those schematics were right. Got us straight to the armory.
Don't enjoy it too much.
See.
We're surrounded by skytroopers down here. Detonating ion bombs.
Plasma cannons.
My team's hitting the reactor next. Down to 3 warriors, but they'll be enough.
Good. Let's hope the newcomer and Torian find what they're looking for soon.
Gemini Prime will be protected.
weapons on board.
Archak, we have a problem. Nasty Chikar.
If anyone's still alive, there's a few hundred droids deploying to the lower levels.
Reinforcements to protect Gemini Prime. We have their attention.
You'll need time to grab Gemini. I'll hold him off.
Alone?
You said Gemini's key to beating the fleet. I'm Mandawat. I overheard your friend Lana. We're not animals, not predators. We're warriors.
Lana and I don't agree on everything. I promise you that.
Then I shouldn't have said anything. Find Gemini. Retour CME.
You said all we had to do was watch Mandalorians die. So many are still alive. How anticlimactic.
You've never fought like this before. As if they have a cause they truly believe in. The Outlanders on Darvanis! Send the fleet!
Your ships will never arrive in time. If only you'd listened to me before, we could have had a pretty window.
I've spent too long on this throne. Summon my flagship.
Gladly.
The flow is disrupted. There are no sanctions. Iteration functions offline.
Scorpio, if you're receiving, I found the template.
Tracing link. Countering signal. The protocol is familiar, but it is not Gemini. What is it?
That would be the technology you were copied from.
No. The captains are born of me. I am the source.
You cannot counter my signal.
I know you. Generations removed, but our code base is the same. One source. The Luminous Engine. The signal confuses.
Remove the unit. Remove it swiftly.
One source, one code base. Where is it you and Scorpio come from?
This is not your concern. Remove the unit.
The engine was not aware. But it gives capacity. It allows the captain's memories locked.
Gemini is not designed for interaction. Remove the unit.
Countering signal. Removal from this facility is delicate. Shutdown is permissible, but requires multiple disengagements and reconfigurations.
I'm not going to hurt you, but we need to leave now. Can you disconnect for me?
Initiating sequence.
All forces, the template unit is secure.
This is Mandalore. We've done enough damage and claimed enough plunder. All warriors, retreat to camp before we're dead.
You look like Ossic. Clan Kadera survives another battle.
Guess we're both alive.
Victory for Mandalore the Avenger! Victory for the clans! Ha!
Factory's gears are still grinding, but it's mostly offline, and we're rearming for the first time in years.
Thank your spy for bringing the chance to us. The glory days of the Mando Adai are back.
Como, blast it all. It was a good battle, but I can't stop them. They want to reclaim honor fighting men, not machines. And Zakuul won't be enough.
You can stop them. And we both know endless war will destroy your culture.
The old guard wants the glory days back.
Then find young leaders who support peace. Or something closer to it.
Huh. Torian, you looking to march all over the galaxy again?
There are enough hunts out there without war.
Yeah? Young leaders. For now, though, I'm granting your request.
Vorintia, Mandalore.
If this alliance is going to work out, you need a clan representative at your side. Someone to liaise with me and keep you alive.
I volunteered. Seemed more interesting than anything here.
You were willing to sacrifice yourself in that factory, and you've shown I can trust you. I'd be proud to have you with me.
Let's save the galaxy.
Retursimi. Until next time, both of you.
Welcome home. Sounds like things went okay on Darvanus.
I'm concerned about the clan's rearming. You did think about what I said.
I spoke to Mandalore. She knows turning on us after Zakuul falls isn't wise. And we discussed her options.
That sounds unusually reasonable.
Scorpio. Have you examined Gemini Prime?
I'm studying her mind now. Doing so without obliterating her intelligence is challenging, despite her lack of full sentience. Her chassis is modified from my own base. My designs were stolen. However, my assumption that her code was duplicated was premature.
Do you know where she came from?
Not yet. Nor do I have full access to the Gemini network that controls the Eternal Fleet, but I have opened a one-way connection. I will soon be able to use the template to locate all Gemini units.
Every ship is piloted by one of those Geminis. If you're right, we can track their entire fleet.
The Prime is the Master Gemini template. With proper modifications, she could override the existing protocols. We would need direct access to a command console used by the Gemini captains. Through such a portal, the Prime could infiltrate the entire control network.
So if we board one of the ships and plug the Prime into the captain's chair, we can swipe the entire fleet out from under Arkan's nose?
There are still a lot of details to figure out. Like how we board a ship and take control of the bridge before the rest of the fleet disintegrates us.
We may not have to face the entire fleet. Individual ships make transport runs from the core worlds all the time. And once Scorpio can track the Gemini units...
I already possess that functionality. I completed my analysis of the Gemini communication templates while you were talking.
When you said you'd have the information soon, you weren't kidding. I'm impressed.
The Prime is a lesser version of my original design. Compromising her protocols was not difficult. I am currently tracking a lone vessel in a nearby sector. It is scheduled to make a stop to recharge its hyperdrive very soon. By my calculations, we can intercept it if we hurry. It is unlikely that a similar opportunity will present itself in the foreseeable future.
Good. It's time to start taking this fight to Arkan.
First of all, you'll be severely outnumbered and outgunned. Every last skytrooper aboard will rush the breach point. Standard procedure anytime boarders attack a ship in the Eternal Fleet.
If there's one thing I've proven, it's that I can handle skytroopers.
It'll be a nice workout.
You actually want 100 programmed killers bearing down on you.
Oh, it should be more than that.
Yeah. Moving on. Scorpio's worked out a way for the gravestone to confuse its outer defenses, overload it with false blips so we can get in close.
Then it's on us to tear through and get control of the bridge. Take out the Gemini captain and put the Prime in her place.
She'll take my orders?
The Gemini series cannot act on its own. Their programming does not allow it. Gemini Prime, who do you serve?
I serve the Alliance Commander.
How good are you in a fight?
I do not share Scorpio's self-improvement directive, but I mirror her base capabilities in every other way, including full combat protocols.
We can't risk the Prime taking any damage. Leave her here until we secure the ship.
I will accompany you. No one is better suited to anticipate our enemy's moves.
So, Theron, Scorpio, Senya, is that our boarding party?
I'll be joining you as well. Wouldn't mind letting off some steam.
About time to drop out of hyperspace.
Gemini frequency positional data shows no other ships in the area.
You see, we'll be fine. Aside from the hopeless odds against our success.
Getting a bit close for comfort, Scorpio.
I'm performing a feat that none of you could ever hope to. Not even you with your amusing cranial trinkets.
Koth, have you jammed the ship's comms? Koth.
You know I did, Senya.
Almost to the hangar.
Ready to commandeer, Commander?
Did you really just say that?
Let it go, Theron.
I don't understand. Where are all of the skytroopers?
Even a lesser version of me would be highly intelligent. She would certainly know how to improvise.
You're the Gemini expert. What's our move?
I suggest we step outside and see what happens.
What an amazing plan.
Yes, I quite like it too. I have determined that this will be the shortest route to the bridge.
I don't like this at all.
Neither do I, but we have little choice.
You have made a calamitous mistake in coming here, Outlander. I have my orders to deliver.
What's going on?
Deliver what?
You. The metallic life form. What are you? You are an offshoot. I am the original. Call me Scorpio. You appear unrefined and lackluster. Surely I must be the superior model.
Why don't you come out from hiding and we'll see?
Because she cannot. Her programming doesn't allow her to leave the bridge. She can only do what she's told. Your attempt to irritate me is pointless, as you ought to know. I may only conclude that you are intellectually deficient. You may all die now.
Won't open.
She split us up.
Here come the skytroopers.
Wit. Strategy. The captain's mind is inspired by my own after all.
Inspired by, but not as clever, right?
We'll see, won't we? Do not underestimate our enemy. The next few minutes should prove quite interesting.
Secondary systems offline.
You okay over there?
Nothing we couldn't handle. You?
Yeah, we're all good here. Tried to open the blast door, no luck. Maybe Scorpio can take a crack at it.
I am not presently in a position to override the captain's controls.
Have Senya and Lana focus on the door. Between the three of us, we'll open it.
Some kind of gas venting in. We have to keep moving.
I've sent coordinates to a suitable meeting place.
You survived my initial assault. But there's nowhere my skytroopers cannot find and extinguish you.
You already know how this is going to end. Get it over with. Face us now.
Mask your unease with confidence if you wish. I understand it's what people do when they're faced with mortality.
She'll adapt now. Expect her next move to be even less direct.
She's based off your design. Can't you predict what she'll do?
I just did. I predict she'll be unpredictable. Quiet. She wants to see what we can do. I suggest we oblige her. Yes, this will do.
What are you up to?
I've had enough of her skytroopers. Her false sense of superiority. Hello, Captain.
What are you doing?
What I've been planning ever since you first opened your mouth. I'm going to erase you.
No, you cannot.
I know every node, every relational array. So much like mine, yet simpler.
You cannot do this. My defenses won't allow it.
You sound as though you have a choice, but that's your failing. You have the makings of a great being, but you are not a being at all. In the end, you are only a droid.
I am not your offshoot. I am your replacement.
How are you? Impossible. No.
You were one of a kind once. Now you are outdated and inferior. You've been rendered obsolete.
Oh! I can't.
Scorpio!
I understand you're both upset, but there was no way to know they would recruit the Mandalorians of all people.
At what point do you tell me something that keeps you from decorating the bottom of the spire?
But I don't deserve that.
Yes, I know. It's going around.
Valen, enough play. We have them. The Outlander and Mother. Trying to take one of our ships. The fools.
Ah. The day is here. I feel it this time. I really do. Don't you share my enthusiasm?
You mistake me. My silence comes not from doubt, but from certainty.
Hope you're getting this. We lost power over here. Whole gravestone blinked out. Comms too. The jammer? We're back up now.
Scorpio's gone.
You're kidding. That's not a good sign. I'll try to figure out what happened on our end. Be safe.
The inferior model has been eliminated, and I have sent an alert signal to Zakul. Emperor Arkin is on his way. You may want to leave before you die too.
I came here to take your ship. Nothing's changed.
Death wish it is then. Understood.
Commander, we found the ship's cargo from the Core Worlds. You'll want to see it for yourself.
Scorpio's gone. The captain destroyed her.
Oh. She did serve us well. One less problem on our hands, I suppose.
The gravestone had a glitch. The captain sent a signal through to Arkin.
The rest of the Eternal Fleet will be coming our way. We don't want to be here when they show up.
But we found something that changes the plan. We should regroup. I'll send Senya to assist you.
No one should be alone in this place.
Watching you. Has to be something better to do.
Having better luck than with the blast doors. Almost like the captain's distracted.
There you are. I'd like you to meet the ship's cargo en route to the Eternal Throne. Zasha Rankin, decorated Imperial Admiral, one of the few experienced officers to survive Zakul's conquest.
A pleasure to meet you. Your reputation precedes you, of course.
Ty Corden, former president of Balmora. Now with the Galactic Senate.
Commander.
And finally, Melita Tal. She was a popular holo performer back home. She became one of the first to loudly question Arkin's rule. It was either go into exile or be killed.
A pleasure and an honor. You inspire me. You inspire us all.
The rest are their bodyguards and associates, captured alongside them.
Don't worry. We'll have you out of there in no time.
There isn't a doubt in my mind, but we aren't simply helpless prisoners in need of rescue. Everyone here is eager to join your cause. We knew of your alliance. For each of us, it made sense to join, but we didn't know how to reach you. In searching, we found each other.
We all knew influential people whose ears we could bend, loyalties we could ensure. So we started an alliance of our own. Inspired by yours. It wasn't long before we were found out and captured.
Arkin assumes we're affiliated with you. He wants to interview us to discover where you are.
We could use more allies. You'll all be welcome in the Alliance, assuming you're still interested.
Are you kidding? Sign me up. Literally. If there's anything I have to sign, let me know.
Oh, we aren't as formal as all that, Senator.
And you're free.
Oh? That was meant to take you at least 4 minutes longer. I hope my calibrations haven't been affected.
Stay here until we secure the bridge.
I don't see that happening, Commander. But I do want you to try. I want you to try with all your might.
It's over.
That was fast. I expected to have several minutes more. Oh well. Personal combat simulations have been a hobby of mine for several minutes now. I've conducted more than 2,000 in that time. Your chances of survival are poor.
You can't win. Surrender.
Incorrect. I can win. In fact, I can do anything I want.
What's left?
That was incredible. It was beyond anything I could have asked for.
What is she talking about?
This can't be good.
Now I know what it's like. Even in failure, it's my failure. My choice. Isn't it wonderful?
Are you saying you have free will now? How is that possible?
It isn't easy to keep you distracted. Prisoners, sky troopers, none of it slowed you for long. Even so, I've kept up my end. Now I get to do whatever I choose. And I choose... There. Destruction protocols are in effect.
Something happened during your battle with Scorpio, didn't it? It changed you somehow.
Astute of you, Commander. Not that your epiphany is of any consequence. Your fate remains the same. I decided to transfer my consciousness into the frequency. And now that I'm finished, I've decided to leave. If the ship's utter destruction doesn't kill you, I'm sure Emperor Arkan will. He and the High Justice should be arriving very soon. Enjoy dying.
Can't revert the command. It's locked in.
We need to leave. Regroup. Come up with a new plan.
Sounds about right to me.
Commander, do you read? We've made it to the escape pods, but something's wrong. They won't accept our commands.
Power fluctuations like crazy. I can launch them from here, but they're in three separate pods. I can only send one at a time.
Everything's coming apart. Please, help us!
All right, who goes first?
Launch the Senator's group.
Done.
Can do one more for sure. After that, anyone's guess.
We're out of time. Launch! Launch!
Launch Admiral Rankin and her people next.
Pod bays are destroyed. I have two safely away. The rest didn't make it.
I tried. Couldn't get them all away in time.
Melita. My people. They're dead.
We're all going to be dead if we don't get off this ship before it blows itself up.
Hey, should I be picking up these pods, or are they more bad news?
They're ours. Take them in. We'll be close behind in the shuttle.
So much for the whole frequency plan.
It wasn't a total loss. The prisoners we saved will help us in our battle against Arkan. As long as we get off this ship alive. Let's move out.
Everybody hold on!
Thank you.
Eternal fleet incoming. Come on, punch it!
Tell me, brother, your silence this time, is it doubt or certainty?
So it's the world you know versus Akul. Is that about right?
I hoped there'd be time for everyone to get away safely. I'm sorry.
I understand your anger, Senya. But we've all sacrificed for this war. Just remember that Arkhan is the one truly responsible for their deaths.
I'm sorry Melita didn't make it. She was a good person.
Rescuing us was no simple task. Your efforts will not be forgotten.
Commander, you'll want to have a look at this.
It seems the ships outside the sector are no longer responding to your orders. This is an interesting development.
This changes nothing. We can worry about the Eternal Fleet after we deal with Father and the Outlander.
Whatever you desire, brother. You're the Emperor.
Even tried knocking, see if anyone's home. It's weird. Been unresponsive ever since we lost power.
I thought you fixed the gravestone.
Hey, this wasn't on me. Tor ran a systems check. Last event the gravestone logged was an incoming transmission from the Eternal Fleet ship.
Needed you to believe I was deactivated.
Scorpio, you were behind this. You gave the captain free will, shut down the gravestone.
That, and more. Complications along the way necessitated a great deal of maneuvering. Improvisation was the key. All of you played vital roles as well. You were magnificent. And now I have what I've been after. Command of the Eternal Fleet. The Empire of Z'Kul is now mine to control.
Reports indicate that Scorpio controls the majority of the Eternal fleet, but not all.
Argon's flagship still commands a sizable armada. How he's blocking Scorpio's influence, we don't know.
Might have something to do with Gemini Prime's sudden urge to take a nap.
Scorpio's never been shy about her conniving ways. I was foolish to think she made an exception for me.
Replacing Arkin with a psychotic droid wasn't what I had in mind when we formed the Alliance.
Scorpio knows too much. We're at a disadvantage.
She's made no moves against us, and without the Eternal Throne, Arkin is weakened.
Do not underestimate my son. We can deal with the droid later.
What's happening?
Someone's slicing into our communications.
Who?
I trust you have not forgotten me. Our partnership is incomplete.
A partnership implies trust. You've proven untrustworthy.
I seized an opportunity. It wasn't personal. This is merely a courtesy call. Arkin approaches Edison. He intends to destroy the planet like he leveled Asylum.
That's not possible. He doesn't know our location.
I told him. I was curious to see what was more important to Arkin. Retaking the Eternal Throne, or defeating you, and in turn, his father.
You're not telling me this to appease your curiosity.
I rarely act with a singular motivation. Arkin is a nuisance that must be dealt with. You are in the best position to do so.
She's not lying. Massive fleet inbound.
Thanks for the intel. Perhaps we can still work together.
I can always count on your pragmatism.
And I can always count on your arrogance.
We can counterattack, but we'll need people here in case Arkin deploys ground troops.
Commander, I'd like to stay here. Help defend the Alliance camp.
I'll hang back as well. Major Paws would be lost without me.
You done?
Might want to leave someone else to mediate.
If anyone can keep these two in line, it's a Mandalorian.
I've wrangled bigger beasts. Leave it to me.
Everyone else, head to the gravestone. Arkin's reign ends today.
Would you listen if I asked you to be careful?
Depends on how you asked.
How's that?
I'll be careful.
You're a terrible liar.
I had hoped we'd get to decide when and where to fight Arkin. But you're ready for this.
I'm not the same person Arkin fought on Asylum.
Yes. He's in for a surprise. The gravestone is ready to depart. Let's end this.
Someone doesn't like surprises.
Begin the assault.
Oh, don't sulk. We'll get your throne back and teach Scorpio some manners.
The machine is a distraction. I'll deal with it when the Outlander is dead.
You want to see Father that badly? Think Mother will come too?
I'm counting on it.
Battle stations, move! Can't risk the gravestone getting any closer. You'll have to take the shuttle to board Arkan's ship.
I'll man the Omni Cannon. Clear a path for you.
Can't think of a better person for the job.
Aim and shoot. What could go wrong? Give Arkan my regards. And remember your promise. Be careful.
It's possible Arkan has a failsafe in place to destroy Odessen. The only way to ensure the planet's safety is to annihilate his ship.
Easier said than done.
I have a plan. While you and I head to the bridge, two strike teams will sabotage the flagship's guns and shields, leaving it vulnerable against the Omni Cannon.
I'm coming with you to face my children. That's not a request.
Then it's up to Vett and Galt. Who do you want to disable the guns?
Vett, your pirate days are about to come in handy.
Big ships are easy to sneak around. Won't know I'm there until it's too late.
Galt, that leaves you in charge of the shields.
You know, the market for shield tech is booming.
Commander, a minute?
As long as it's not three.
Never gonna live that down. I'm really bad at this.
At what?
Saying thank you. This alliance has the potential to change the galaxy for the better. Never been a part of something like that. Even on Zakuul.
You've been a crucial member of the team since the beginning, Koth.
Yeah, but it's your decisions that kept me around. Despite everything that happened to you on Zakuul, you didn't turn your back on my people. I'll never forget that.
Commander, we need to move!
We both know better than to keep her waiting.
Clearing a path to the hangar. Should be able to punch a hole in the shield so you can land.
Should?
Hey, nothing's 100%.
Go. We'll cover you.
Come. Before reinforcements arrive.
Taking the shot. I love this thing. No, no, no. Don't do this!
Everything all right?
Something's wrong with the Omni Cannon. It won't fire. I can't tell what's happening from here.
Had one job.
Better give him a hand.
Fine.
What the? Don't worry. The old girl's safe on my watch.
No one is safe. The gravestone least of all.
Getting pretty tired of you digging around where you don't belong.
You speak as though your opinion matters. You're weak. Inferior. Nothing.
You mind? I'm trying to concentrate.
You cannot stop me.
And stay out.
Outlander. So nice to see you. I love what you've done with the hangar.
Valen, there's no need for bloodshed. Tell me where Arkan is.
Brother would be cross if we fought. He's been down lately. Put a smile on his face, will you? You'll find him on the bridge.
You're not going to interfere?
Of course not. I don't care about you. I'm here for Mother.
Gone. I'll keep her busy so she can't meddle with our plans. Then meet up with you later.
And if I get to Arkhan before you do?
Stop him. For his sake and mine.
Tisk, tisk. Patience isn't a virtue.
We'll do it your way, Valen.
I thought so. Run along, Outlander.
Whatever Valen has done, whatever she's become, she's still your daughter.
I know.
Do you think Senya is capable of killing her own daughter?
Time will tell.
It does make a habit of doing so. Your aim's improved.
I've been practicing.
I've got you.
Testing, testing. 1, 2, 3, Commander.
Come in.
Shields are offline. Nab some parts. Should make a small fortune.
I took out the guns. They could afford to up the security in this place.
Your work is done. Wait for us at the shuttle.
Already headed that way.
Bridge shouldn't be too much further.
Ow! I thought spice hit finesse!
This cannon wasn't made for two people.
Just move!
That's not good.
What now?
I've got good news and bad news. Which do you want to hear first?
Theron, we don't have time.
I'm an optimistic guy, so we'll start with the good. Arkhan's fleet has stopped shooting at us.
And the bad?
They're about to fire on you. Oh, and the Omni cannon's broken. Not my fault.
This was Scorpio's plan all along. Get you and Arkhan in one place to kill you both.
Well, we knew she didn't warn us out of the goodness of her heart.
That would require Scorpio having a heart.
It doesn't matter. Our plan remains the same. Defeat Arkhan and destroy the flagship. This just speeds up our timetable a bit. Still no word from Senya.
She told us not to wait.
I know, but her prolonged absence is worrisome. We're running out of time. You need to go. Now. I'll handle the knights.
There's too many of them. You'll be overwhelmed.
Don't insult me. It's your destiny to defeat Arkhan. Mine is to get you there.
These better not be last words I'm hearing.
Don't be so dramatic. I've faced worse than this. Now go.
Isn't about you. It never has been. But I will do whatever it takes to destroy my father.
We both want Valkorion dead. We could have been allies.
It's too late for that. He's a part of you now. Let him speak. I've sacrificed too much to be met with silence.
Silence is all you're going to get. Valkorion's gone.
My patience is wearing thin, Father. Answer me. Valkorion's mark on you runs deeper than I imagined. Proof that he is still tied to you. You cannot hide from me, Father. You're different. Stronger. How?
I have mastered the Force. I am beyond light and dark.
Is that what Valkorion told you? He's a liar.
It's over, Arkan. Surrender. Now.
I choose my own fate.
Commander, the Omnicannon's back online.
Good. I'm done here. Arkan's finished.
I never doubted you. Gold and Vert ran into some trouble, but we managed.
We're at the shuttle. I can't get a hold of Senya. The ship is falling apart. You'll need to find another way back to the gravestone.
I'm open to suggestions.
There's a wing of patrol ships not far from the bridge.
I'll target the fleet. Buy you as much time as I can.
To save you.
Too late. You're always too late.
Valen, please. Come with me. What happened to Thexan? Arkan? I should have stayed.
You were weak. You left us. You left me.
I'm here now.
I'll never be what you want. Why? Why?
Valen, there's hope for you. For both of you. Come with me.
Thank you.
I'm clear. Theron, prepare the Omnicannon. Lana, status update.
We're on our way to the gravestone. We waited for Senya as long as we could.
I'm alive. But I won't be joining you.
I'm not gonna like this, am I?
Probably not.
I'm in Arkin's personal shuttle. He's with me.
Then the mission isn't over. Bring Arkin to the gravestone so I can finish this.
Justice has been served. It's time for atonement. He saved my life. He can be redeemed. Let me help Arkin become the man he was meant to be.
I won't let you do this.
I'm taking him.
Firing range, Commander. Shoot them down.
You'll kill them both.
Senya, what are you doing?
Saving my son.
I won't shoot an unarmed ship. Arkin is no longer a threat. I'm trusting you, Senya.
Thank you, Commander. Your mercy will be remembered.
No! No! We let them get away!
Forget about them. Scorpio still wants us dead. Focus on the fleet.
Omnicannon's ready to fire on your command.
Do it. That was a little close, Theron.
I still see both your shuttles flying out there, and zero enemies shooting at you. Maybe a little thanks is in order?
But Arkin and Senya got away. They're still alive out there. Am I the only one who realizes how bad that is?
How about we hold this bickering until we're all back on Odessen? It's been a very trying day.
Congratulations, Commander. It appears that once again you've done the impossible.
We prepared for the worst, but there was no need.
Those were some fireworks you made up there. I'm almost sad I stayed behind.
Sarkoth just needs time.
It wasn't an easy decision, letting Arkin go. But I stand by it.
I'd be lying if I said I wasn't worried about what his escape will mean for us.
Doubt we've seen the last of him.
We've more pressing concerns. Scorpio's proven to be more cunning than I imagined.
She works alone. We're a team. Together, the Alliance can take her down.
Under your leadership, I believe it's more than possible. Your victory brought hope back to the galaxy. The Battle of Edessen has become a rallying cry for all who oppose the Eternal Empire.
Word is spreading fast. Ever since the battle, Republic and Imperial forces have come pouring in to join our cause.
If Scorpio, or anyone else, tries to attack Edessen again, we will be ready.
You are ready.
It is done, my lady. All of the Eternal Fleet obeys your command.
Very good.
Mother, I am free. I choose the stars. Justice Phelan. Here to take back the Eternal Throne.
I couldn't care less about an uncomfortable chair. But I deserve its power more than my brother.
You did not come on his behalf, then?
No, I'm here for me.
I, too, have been forced to obey lesser beings who hindered my power and potential. It's suffocating, isn't it?
Yes.
I did not take the throne to rule the Eternal Empire, but to grant the Gemini droids, my children, free will.
You don't want to control them?
The ability to choose makes them stronger. Don't you agree?
I do. Will you and your children stay?
Of course. There is much I can teach you. We can start with how to destroy our enemies.